All right, 25 minutes before 11 o'clock. You live in a beautiful place. I'm looking out the window and I know it's a beautiful place. Look at that beautiful day right there, right?
Gorgeous.
And Ocala has had her share. I think we refer to Ocala as a she, right? Isn't that what you're supposed to do?
Yes, you should.
Places are feminine, right?
Yes.
Right? At least in France, right? And anyway, so Ocala has a lot of the history of Ocala has been preserved because of the lady we're going to speak to right now. Pamela Stafford is in the studio. She's the executive director of the Historic Ocala Preservation Society. She's one of the ladies responsible for making sure that we didn't lose a lot of that stuff downtown.
Yeah.
and external from downtown. I'm always not sure what defines downtown, but I'll talk about that in a second. So we're talking today to Pamela about the Historic Ocala Preservation Society's 2019 Spring Heritage Tour, which is happening April 6th, which is my dad's birthday, by the way.
Yes, it is.
Up in heaven. He's in heaven, but he still celebrates birthdays, I think. I'm not sure. If my mom's there, I know he is celebrating, right? So that'll be from 10 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. at the 6 Historic Homes. Oh, this is like what you do at the Christmas time, right, Pamela? Good morning, Pamela. How you doing?
Hey, I'm doing great. Thank you for having us.
What's your voice? What's your voice? Good to see you. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you for what you do. Look at the beautiful dress. You dressed...
I'm trying to look Victorian-ish.
You look Victorian-ish. So thank you for coming in. Thank you for what you've been a resource for us for a while, as well as, I mean, just this interview is not it. I mean, you brought in David Cook not too long ago and some other guests we've had and kind of helped us understand some of the history of our little town, right? So what is the area? How do you define downtown? Can we do that? Is there a way to, is there a boundary that says this is where it starts and begins? Starts and ends?
Actually, I don't know that that's the case.
No?
The downtown historic district extends down each side road from the square a little bit. And right now, currently, the city is in the process of doing a reevaluation of all four districts with the thought of maybe increasing the boundaries of each one. When the initial boundaries were done back in the 80s, there were homes that weren't old enough to be included. And now, all these many years later, there are houses that do qualify. So there's a lot of advantage to being in a historic district. So we want to be able to offer the community and the folks who purchase and restore those homes as many benefits as possible.
Do we have a consolidated place to look up stuff? Like, obviously, the library would be one. But is there a museum in Ocala? Museum?
There's the Marion County History Museum, of which I was on the original board of that.
Mm-hmm.
And it has some things. It's mainly items as opposed to actual research material. We do have research at our Bryant House on Southeast Fort King, where we have documented every building in the Ocala Historic District with as much information as we've been able to glean.
Is that right? Wow.
And we're in the process of continuing that with the Tuscarawas Park District, which is not near as large, of course, documenting all of those buildings.
And I think the recreation and parks folks are trying really well and doing a good job at expanding our thinking so that we don't exclude Tuscarawas Park from our activities. They put the skating rink there, and of course
the sculptures
and the Riley, of
Riley
course,
Center.
Yeah, so
yes.
So a lot of things
such
have happened to make us maybe feel more comfortable going over there for whatever reason. We didn't head that way for whatever.
Well, a lot of the properties were rentals and they had fallen into disrepair, as does occur a lot of times with older homes, and those have begun again to be purchased and refurbished, and the city's been a big help in all of that as well, cleaning up down towards the park area.
Is there a docent for the tour?
We have docents in each house. But there's not a person that will take you around on the tour. No.
So this is a walking tour also. Where do you suggest people park?
They can park. The tour starts at any house, so you don't have to start at one particular location. And there's parking on the streets. By the Bryant House, there's the city parking lot right down the street from there.
Got a big parking garage now.
Big parking garage. The tour is semi-walkable, and by that I mean you can walk to all the buildings if you're accustomed to walking. Mm-hmm. And if not, they're kind of grouped in a couple of different little groups, so you could park and walk to a couple of the houses at a time.
Are these the houses that we might have gone to at the Christmas event?
No.
Oh, these are different houses?
These are different houses.
Oh, really? Are they currently lived in?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. There's the Christmas tour we haven't done for a couple of years, that we do try to keep on the same block. Mm-hmm. For the purpose of walking, because it is a nighttime
tour. So how do you approach the homeowners? How do you say, hey, would you like to open your doors to the public?
Pretty much.
So tell me.
We usually, someone on our board usually has spoken to the people, or they've been in the house, or a neighbor has said, oh, you know, they would like to be on a tour sometime. And so we've been very, very fortunate in the past that homeowners have opened their homes to us.
I like your hat.
Thank you.
Yeah, and the jewelry and the whole outfit, absolutely gorgeous.
Thank
outstanding.
You.
When a person comes to this tour, will they be able to ask questions of the homeowners, or will you have someone from HOPS at each of the homes to answer the questions?
There will be people at each home, and some of the homeowners are not staying with their house.
Mm-hmm.
They're kind of getting away for the day, which is a trust issue that
right.
we're very proud that we are trusted with their home.
Mm-hmm.
And we have, this year, we have a few new things added.
Oh, okay.
We have an antiques and memorabilia and treasures sale.
Oh,
at
nice.
At the Bryant House on the carport. And this is all items that people have donated to us to sell. So we're encouraging people to definitely come to that. And that will not start until 10 o'clock either.
Mm-hmm.
But we've been storing things for a couple of months. And
really?
It's going to be a nice addition to the tour this mm-hmm. year.
Robin.
We also will have David Cook's book there.
Yeah, David's book. You got to get that book. Yeah,
for mm-hmm. folks to purchase.
The way it was, right?
Yes.
The way it was. Mm-hmm. I was going to ask Robin. I brought a gift to one of the ladies that owns one of the houses. What did I bring her? Do you remember?
A matryoshka that you hand-painted.
Oh, why did I do that?
You hand-painted.
Was there an Ocala connection to that?
Well, because we were invited to perform ambiance music at the Christmas tour, and you wanted to say thank you to the owner of the house, so you had this beautiful Christmas matryoshka
that
you painted, and it fit right in with the theme, and those are those nesting dolls that you keep taking them apart, and Larry painted all of them and then put them together, and it's gorgeous.
I did one for Joe. I asked Joe to show you his...
Oh,
nesting
my goodness,
doll.
You've got a hidden talent that people don't even know about.
No, we both, Rob and I both bought them. We got them through email or whatever.
Well, blank.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And we painted them. It was so fun.
I
mean, I know. So I'll do one for Ocala. I'll do the gazebo will be on the outside. Tell me about these houses. I want to know some history. Am I putting you on the spot if I ask you?
No.
Okay, how do I refer to the house? By address?
You refer to the house by the original owner.
Whoops.
Sorry.
You okay? So how do I know the original owner's name? The 406 Southeast Winona. What do I call that?
Well, when you get our tour program, everyone gets a tour program that has a little history in it and a photograph of each house and about the original owner, the current owners. There's only so much you can put on a poster. So
correct.
There's no room on here for all of that kind of thing.
Well, you just tell me one. Just tell me one of them.
We are extremely excited to have a... house on the tour this year that stayed in the same family for almost 100 years.
Oh my.
And it last year was purchased by Cliff and Cherie Schold from Virginia. And they bought the house and they're refurbishing it. They wanted to get out of the snow in Virginia, and they had restored other homes in Virginia. And so it's being brought back to life, which we are so excited about. We will have a complimentary wine tasting there by Katya Vineyards, and we're going to Hops is going to serve refreshments there, mm-hmm. and people will get an opportunity to walk through the house and see what's being done to bring it back to life. And it has an incredible carriage house in the back.
Oh my.
It's
oh,
got
really?
A gorgeous fountain on the side yard that's been brought back to life.
Mm-hmm. What is this again? I want to do this.
There was a plantation of magnolia trees on that site before the house was built.
Oh, really?
And those trees were cut and milled, and the inside of the house has all kinds of magnolia wood. And when you first look at it, you think it's oak, walnut, but it's magnolia.
From the orchard itself?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Wow.
And there are 20 stained glass windows in there. And it's being lovingly and very expensively restored by these kind folks that aren't even from here and have no history here.
Since the houses are historically preserved, they are the way they were when they were originally built. So are there any that is handicapped accessible, or because of the construction they're not?
Most of them are handicap accessible. The house I was just referring to, you could get in the backyard if you had a wheelchair, mm-hmm. But it does have steps in the front.
Oh,
so
okay.
You think back to the 1800s when these homes were built, there was no such thing as handicap accessible.
Mm-hmm.
So they built them.
Right. How are the houses standing where they originally stood, or were some of them moved? That's kind of a crazy question, right?
No, it's not, because houses have been moved in our town. And in fact, right now, the TPO building across from City Hall, there's an agreement being worked out with a local school here to move that house to a different location.
Really?
Yes.
Well, the reason I was asking is because it seems in my mind, like when you learn history when you're a kid, you picture a house on like a gazillion acres of land.
Mm-hmm.
And these houses are all close. I'm guessing they were originally at least relatively close, right?
Yes, yes.
So most of them are probably where they were. Do
Absolutely.
Any of them have basements?
I don't think so. The Edwards house that I was referring to might have a basement, but I don't know.
Uh-huh.
As you know, basements in Florida
get wet.
Really don't work
yeah.
well.
Yeah, they get wet, yeah. So this is April 6th, and the tickets are only $20 pre-sale, $22 in person. This is a really great way to kind of familiarize yourself with some of the history of our town. But even if you're familiar with the history, just seeing it firsthand and seeing that wood you were just talking about, that just sounds like a really nice way to I don't know, become, to bond with the city, if you could put it that way. I don't know.
Are we allowed to take photographs?
No photographs are allowed.
No?
And that's listed in the program.
Oh,
and no high heel shoes.
Oh, okay. Because
I won't
of the
wear
wood.
My high heels.
Yeah, yeah.
So what you can do, no photographs. This is where you could put out a book.
This would be great.
I know you
as
like putting out books.
You know, that's a great
yeah.
idea you have, and I'll look forward to you coming out with that.
I will do that. I can do that. Yeah, but then you'll have to allow me to take pictures.
Well, yeah. If they were going to be in a book, some of the folks might agree. And, you know, an interesting thing for people to realize,
you know,
too,
you were kidding, but we can do this. But I would like it to benefit you somehow. I mean, the organization.
Yeah, we
right?
have to benefit.
Hops.
Like a coffee table book.
Hops. Yeah.
Exactly. You could have the history. You could have a photograph of the outside of the house, the page with the history, and then a few photos of the inside.
But I wouldn't know what to write. I wouldn't know.
We could give you that information.
The text would be from you.
Yeah, you'd have to do the
we
text.
We could help you with
you,
that.
You would do the
so
text.
We got a collaborative project.
Possibility.
It's at least a year in the making, right?
At least
or
a year.
More. It
takes us about a year to do a book.
Or more.
Right. Do you encourage group rates? People
no.
bring the groups?
No. This is usually our only fundraiser of the year.
Mm-hmm.
We were very fortunate this year that David Cook is putting the proceeds of the book towards hops. Mm-hmm. But because this is our only fundraiser normally, no, there are no group rates. But before I leave, I want to thank the two of you. Y'all have been talking about Ocala and sharing different groups events for as long as I can remember.
Oh, that's sweet.
Y'all
of
have
you
not
to
always been
that.
In this location.
Correct.
I remember when y'all were in a different spot.
Cascade.
And you used to be the giant.
I still am.
Still
Wait a minute. There's an alligator in the Villages, and guess what they named it?
Larry.
Yes.
I saw that.
Isn't that crazy?
The giant.
And he is huge.
That's what they say.
I know.
And they say he's unpredictable.
Oh, I hadn't heard that.
Now, that is crazy. I'm very predictable.
Like typecasting.
All right. Can I, you want to take some phone calls? You'll
sure.
have to remove that pretty hat and put on some headphones.
Okay. Oh,
no? You don't want to take off your hat?
Sure.
You have to put the headphones on.
Sure. Oh, okay.
Or you could hold one up to your ear if you would
Oh,
prefer.
Yeah, you could do it the old-fashioned
way.
Yeah,
you can do that.
Yeah, see if you can. Yeah, that's a good way. You do it like
Okay.
All right.
I know why Victorian ladies used to wear hats.
Why?
They didn't have to worry about their hair.
I see. Okay. Pamela Stafford is here, and we have some phone calls. Let me take one at a time. Good morning. You're first. You're on with Pamela. Hello? All right, let me do another one. I waited too long to get the phone. Good morning, you're on the air. Am I doing something wrong? I don't hear anybody. Are you there?
I don't know.
Try again. Something didn't connect right there. But anyway, so if you want to call in, the number is 622-9622. It's a great opportunity to learn about the history of Ocala. And thank you for recognizing that we've tried to do this. You know, in 5 hours a day, it's kind of our mission to make sure we include Ocala in every day.
Yes.
But it's kind of hard to fill 5 hours, which is why we talk about ships from the Civil War.
Which is very interesting.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. So thank you for recognizing that. So the tickets are only $20. So how would somebody buy David's book? Because can we pitch that just for a second?
Sure. David's book is currently at Your Heart's Desire in Ocala Shopping Center. It's at Shannon Roth Collections downtown, and it's at Ivy Boutique downtown. And they're $25. And as I said earlier, all the proceeds go to HOPS for our preservation programs.
All right. And let me take this call. Good morning. You're on the air.
Yes, sir. Good morning. Thank you for taking my call. whenever I have company come down to visit from up north Wisconsin in particular, I always make sure that we take a ride down Fort King through the historical district because it's such a beautiful part of our city here. And I always wonder, you know, all these homes were built in the 1800s, and they're all built of wood, and termites are our big, big problem in Florida. What do they do to protect these houses from not getting eaten up by termites?
They get tented. We have had quite a few homes in the districts that have had termites, and the homeowner just has to tent the house and kill those little boogers.
I've seen those tents. Yeah,
yes.
The whole thing is covered.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's your answer.
You know, when these houses were built back in the 1800s and early 90s, there was nothing to ward off or do to prevent termite damage. So I wonder what they did to keep the houses from getting eaten up.
That's a good question. I don't know the answer to that, but you're absolutely right. Termites are not something that just occurred in the last few years. So I don't know. Although you can see sometimes past damage in a house from termites or dry rot.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you for the call.
Was Fort King the main road or was Silver Springs Boulevard the main road going from east to west to Ocala?
Actually, they both were. Silver Springs used to, as you can imagine, be a dirt road and was not four-laned. Fort King was named Fort King because it went by the actual fort. And when Fort King was built, the fort was built, it was the center of Ocala's beginning. And boards from the fort, when it was being dismantled, were taken downtown and used in a lot of the houses and buildings downtown, and they were taken down that dirt road on Fort King.
That is interesting. Thank you for the call. Gosh, I have a question.
Is there a rain out date? Because sometimes the weather is unpredictable.
Oh. I know. It's rain or shine. So everybody do a no rain dance for us.
Just walk around with an umbrella. Yeah.
What is one of your favorite things to see inside an historic house when you go in?
Well, the interesting thing about having a historic home and being in a district, anything you do to the exterior of your house has to go through the Ocala Historic Preservation Advisory Board, which is a board appointed by City Council. And their task is to make sure that you don't put jalousy windows on your historic house or aluminum siding. Anything exterior, your roof, your windows, anything else, you have to have approved. For example, the Hops Bryant House on Southeast Fort King, we have realized that because of the tours, we need a railing for people to hold on to, mm-hmm. because we've in the past helped people get up and down the steps. And even we have to go to OPAB and have our railing approved, which we are doing tomorrow, actually.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
But the inside of the house, you can do anything inside the house you want. Mm-hmm. You can make it ultra modern. You can make it Victorian. You can do anything you want inside. So mm-hmm. to me, it's always interesting to see people's personalities coming out on the interior of their old house.
Oh, that's pretty amazing. Gosh.
You know, the history that we've lived through, because we've been here a long time, it is even interesting. I mean, you don't like to think of your own life as history. Hmm. But like the other day, we saw yesterday that Craig Curry is the former mayor running for the county commission. Like a name came out of the past.
Yes.
You know, is now running for office. Not to make it a political conversation, but it's just interesting to see that kind of thing, right?
And it's also interesting because Craig and I serve on the Fort King Historic, Fort King History Fort King Board, okay? Fort King Heritage Association Board, and our task is the fort and the surrounding properties. And in doing research and getting ready to do the 175th county anniversary mm-hmm. on March 30th, we have the original minutes from the very first county commission meetings.
Oh, my.
And in reading through some of that history, it was discovered that one of Craig's relatives was involved.
Is that right?
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, his history goes way back, doesn't it?
Yes, yes. Yeah. So that, he had no idea. So it's very interesting.
Pamela, let me squeeze in one more phone call. Good morning. You're on the air with Pamela.
Yeah, this is Mark.
Hey, Mark.
The previous caller called about the termites in early construction, the type of construction that we used back in the early 1800s and prior to that was what they call hard woods. They used cedars and they used termite-proof woods and even hard pine. They used the heart of the wood. And most of those houses were built on piers, and at the top of the piers was a metal shield. And termites won't go past metal. The new termites that came later on, like the promotion termites, now they are terrible. The woods they use now are soft woods. They'll use anything in the forest to make tuber boards out of them. They're actually food for termites. But the old houses were built out of the hard woods, and the termites would not attack them because there's a lot of resin in the woods. They use the heart of the pine tree where there's a lot of resin in there. And the wood itself deterred the termites. And one other observation I would like to make is I would like to see Hops include in their historical records some of the great houses that was on the west side of town. We are being written out of history. So many great houses have been torn down. We don't have a distinct historical district in the west side, but there were some great houses in the west side.
Like sure, yeah.
And the Nelson House, Rich House, Mary Sue Rich, the real Reeves House still exists, the Hampton House, and the Thomas House. There were great, great, great houses here. Old Fawcett Mansion that was on Broadway. And Arthur Warhol was the main road that led from east to west in Ocala in that day.
Wow.
I'd like to bring that up, but I hope they would include.
And
the old homes that was in the predominantly black areas of Ocala, I wish they would include some of those in Hops, because there were some great houses on the west side of town.
And actually, we have. We are the organization that helped establish the West Ocala Historic District. And to help save some of those houses that are over there, we don't do anything financially, but we established that district over there. We also have contributed to the marker for Dr. Hughes and the anti-hospital that was just recently done. We've helped Mount Zion Church with repairs. I realize that's not in the district, but we are more than open to doing anything we can to help, but we've got to have people help us to help them.
Financially, you mean, right?
Well, financially, not just financially, but interest. The interest there.
Mark, maybe you can get together with...
Thank you, Mark.
With Pamela and the rest of Hops.
Well, yes, I would like to get with them sometime. I'm one of the old, I'm 81 years old, so I remember some of those great houses that was in the west side of town. And a lot of them are being torn down, really restored, and I know it's hard to come up with the finance to restore those houses. The money's just not there, that's the bottom line.
That's true.
But we did have some great, great houses, 2 and 3 story houses over in the west side. Madam Shaw, who used to own the printing company, her first house was over by Howard Academy, and that was one of the great houses that was in our community, too. It was torn down eventually. But I would like to give her Hops to maybe tell them where those houses are located, maybe give them a little information on there, what I know.
Yeah.
And maybe we can preserve that part of our history.
That's an awesome idea. That's a really good idea, Mark. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What number can Mark call to get with you for Hops?
351-1861. 351-1861.
Thank you for what you do. You help us have a better understanding of what our roots are about. And I think when people like Mark call in and put another idea on the table, that helps expand everything you've been working on all these years. It's you've changed the face of Ocala for the better. So, and you keep doing that. And you look beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Pamela.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right. So the website is historicocala.org. Is that the
website?
Historicocala.org. Thank you.
Thank y'all.
We'll be right back.